very surprising to me that he said that his one of the lesser known facts about him is that he loves to stalk girls. And that he's really trying his best to get a girlfriend, but till now he has had to content himself with crushes. And today, he is in fact going to share a little bit on the lines of crushes, and he's got a very interesting speech title. His speech title is Level 1 Project 2, which is about presenting the topic and then getting feedback, improving on it and re-delivering the speech the next time. His speech title is The Strongest Word in the Dictionary. Okay. So the strongest word in the dictionary, with the loudest round of applause to Mr. Sanjay.
I'm going to tell you a story of two friends, two girls. One, Pallavi. One, Anjali. Pallavi was this kind of girl who has extreme amount of sass. If you don't know what sass means, like, you know, the most popular girl, the one who always fiddles with the hair. She's that type of girl. And the other girl is Anjali. She's a very diligent student. She always, you know, likes to read her books. She likes to study a lot. She's that kind of girl. Pallavi is one who mostly extroversion, the one who goes out, talks to people, while Anjali is always to herself. These both have such contrasting characters. No one would even imagine that these both would get together. Yet, our education system brought them together. Because, like any other people in our country, obviously, education for parents means a lot, right? So, Pallavi used Anjali to help her in educating herself and help her in improving the academic performance. But as the years passed by, they just started to get to know each other really well, and they got this kind of bond which you would often associate with lovers. Like, you know, you see those two girls and you're like, yeah, they are meant to be lovers, right? That's Pallavi and Anjali. This went on like so well until 8th grade when things got a bit bully. This when the entrance of Raj came. Raj is that kind of person who's really popular in school and who has done the most crazy of things in life. I mean, he started drinking in the age of 8th grade. He used to be on Facebook when nobody was there. He was that kind of guy. And Anjali, she had a huge crush on him. But the problem here is, he was popular. And Pallavi, well, she was popular too. So she thought, okay, why not try for this guy? She knew that Anjali may have a crush on him. But reputation is more important, right? So Pallavi went for it and broke Anjali's heart. And as they start, and as this relationship became so complex that, you know, they, an 8-year-old relationship broke apart because of one person, Raj. And what did Raj do? He just sat back and enjoyed himself. And, yeah. Sorry, I'm just getting rid of that. So what I'm telling you so far is, there are two girls, okay? There are two girls, and these both people were best friends, and they had a fight, okay? Because of one guy. You know this story, right?
Yes.
Yeah, you know, right? Yeah, you're the popular guy, yeah, I know that. Yeah. You're that guy, pretty much sure. So, okay, this is the story of Pallavi and Anjali, who were in a 7-year-long relationship, and who broke up because of one person, and that person was Raj. Now, the thing about this story is not about Raj, not about the 7-year-old relationship, it's about the conflict. You think the conflict is such a big thing? And obviously, yeah, you can't say that Pallavi was at fault because Pallavi really had a thing for you. But Anjali was not at fault as well because she also had a thing for him. And if they were really good friends, they should have understood, right? But what to do? There's something called as ego that comes in the way. Ego, I would like to abbreviate as 10 of great organizations. Like this company formed by Pallavi and Anjali came to an end just because their ego started playing and they forgot what their friendship was like. Like how good friends they were just because of one guy. Seriously. But then as the years pass by, do you think this really matters? Think about any conflict you have with your friends. Think about anyone who you have had a conflict with. Think about how small that conflict was. Think about whether you still talk to that person. Do you? No. Because you let this come in your way. Ego. It generates from our mind. But little do you know that something else generates from our heart. Sorry generates from our heart, but it's so hard to tell out. We can't really say sorry because, you know, we let our mind work. Because we say, you know, we say, why should I say sorry? He's the one who started it. I still remember that day, 25th July 2018, he pulled my pants and in front of everybody and embarrassed me so much. Yeah, and we tell these things to ourselves, but we forget that we are letting our ego come in the way of our friendship. And friendship is highly important. It is a bond, inseparable for anyone. So it's so important that we keep this friendship alive. Think about that stupid moment again. Like, ah, remember this? It's something really, you know, it's like, oh, I don't even know why we even thought about it. And then if you say sorry to, like, a loved one, you might actually make a better relationship. If you say sorry to your parents, you might improve your communication. I still remember, I had gone for a long drive, and I did one with my parents, and I did one small misturn. My dad got so furious, and I got furious as well. I was like, why is he getting furious at me? Just one mistake. So then I just got out of the car and I sat in the back, and then my dad said, my dad is driving, and then I said, sorry. And then he said, oh, it's okay. And then we stopped the vehicle and said, pardon me. These are small things which happen when you say sorry. And so I would like to say that, say sorry to improve your relationships.